Let's face it, you hate math. I bet math is the most hated subject in school. You think of math as the black paint that corrupts life's beautiful canvas. But people like me see it differently. You see, this black paint gives nature its colors. The canvas of nature cannot work without math. To start off, everything in the world that has existed, does exist, will exist, can be expressed with math code. One of my dad's coworkers actually predicted how Romeo and Juliet would have really ended with mathematical codes. Now let me move on to the irrational number. An irrational number is a number that cannot be expressed as the ratio of two integers, or not x over y. It has an infinite digits and it does not repeat. Well, this means that every single possible combination of numbers is in any irrational number. So let's convert it into ASCII, which is the code for the English alphabet. You can get any string of numbers. So all the people you will meet, the date, the time, the way you die, the answers to the great questions of the universe are in it. Convert it into bitmap, which is like turning numbers into pictures, and you'll get a pixel-perfect representation of the first thing you ever saw on Earth, the last thing you will see before your life leaves you, and every single little moment in between. Everything in the universe can be expressed using irrational numbers. Now let me move on to probably the best known, most famous number man has ever met. It is an irrational number. It's pi. I hope everyone knows that pi is the circumference of a circle divided by its diameter. Okay, there's not too much pi in nature, but obviously any circle in nature would have pi. So let's go to some of the best circles that nature can boast. Okay, you may think that the sun and the moon are good circles, but no, those are pretty bad. One of the best circles include Saturn's rings and the vascular tissues of a plant stem, your pupil. The second best circle in nature is in the rainbow. And you may say, wait, no, rainbows aren't circles, they're arcs. Well, with the conditions are perfect, you can actually see the whole circle of a rainbow. However, the best circle that nature can boast is in the ripple of water that forms in a lake after a raindrop falls in it. Now let me move on to a less known number, although it is used way more in nature. It's the golden ratio. It's everywhere, from your body to bees to the Milky Way. But first, let me define it. If you take a 1 by x rectangle, take out a 1 by 1 square, and you get an x by x minus 1 rectangle. If these two rectangles are similar, meaning the ratios of the two sides are equal, there's only one value of x that works. That value of x is 1 plus the square root of 5 divided by 2 is approximately 1.618. It's an irrational number, and it's the golden ratio. It is represented with the Greek letter phi. Before you go to sleep, let me share with you what the golden ratio spiral is. Okay, so keep cutting the biggest square you can out of these smaller and smaller and smaller rectangles. Because you start with a 1 by phi rectangle, you cut a square, then you cut a square, and cut a square, you keep cutting squares. And then you draw a quarter circle through each square, and you get a spiral. That is the golden ratio spiral. Okay, it's time to wake up, come on. Although you shouldn't have been sleeping in the first place. Let me start with your body. Your body might as well have been written using the golden ratio code, because it's everywhere in your body. First, the ratio of the height of your face to the width of your face is the golden ratio. So is the distance from the center of your eye to the bottom of your teeth, divided by the distance from the bottom of your teeth to your chin. That's the golden ratio too. Okay, so is the width of your eye divided by the width of your iris, and the ratio of the width of your first tooth in your front to the width of your second tooth. Not only in your face, but also in your hands, your arms, and your feet are the golden ratio. Let me go over your arm. The distance from your elbow to your wrist divided by the distance from your wrist to your fingertips is also the golden ratio. The golden ratio is used everywhere in your body, but it's used even more in nature. So let me go to some of the hundreds of examples of the golden ratio in nature. And you will see why it is called the fingerprint of God. Let me start with a snail shell. Can you see like a spiral going through a snail shell? It's like, well, guess what? That's the golden ratio spiral. It's also true for nostilus shells, and that is a very famous case of the golden ratio in nature. Probably the most famous. Isn't it funny to think that your face is related to a snail? Well, your face is also related to hurricanes and the Milky Way. If you imagine hurricanes and the Milky Way, they both have a spiral through them, and those are the golden ratio spiral as well. Not only are we humans have the golden ratio in our body, but so do many, many animals, such as dolphins, starfish, ants, sea urchins, and honeybees. Oh, speaking of honeybees, did you know that if you divide up a colony of honeybees into gender, male and female, the ratio of the number of females to the number of males will be 1.618 every single time. It'll be the golden ratio. You can try it, except I wouldn't recommend it. Now, let me go on to my last example of the golden ratio in nature. It's the hawk. Okay, the body of a hawk is not in the golden ratio, but the way it hunts is. If you're a hawk and you see a prey down below, instinctively, you will spiral down towards it in the golden ratio spiral. The golden ratio truly is the fingerprint of God. Okay, you can take a snooze again because it's math talk again. So, take two terms, any two numbers, and they are the first two terms of a sequence. Each term after that is the sum of the previous two terms. And like, if you take any two terms, let's say 3 and 7, the next term is 3 plus 7 is 10. The next term is 7 plus 10 is 17. Next term is 10 plus 17 is 27, and so on. The terms keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger. When you take the ratio of two consecutive terms, it gets closer and closer to feed the golden ratio. One famous case of this is in the Fibonacci sequence. It starts with two ones, and it goes 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34. I consider it the little brother of the golden ratio, and it is also used a lot in nature. Let's start off with flowers. The number of petals in a flower and the seed heads are a Fibonacci number. Like, for example, let's start with the petals. Lilies have 3 petals. Buttercups have, and a lot of other flowers have 5 petals. Chicoroids have 21, and daisies have 34 petals, all Fibonacci numbers. Now, with the seed heads, it's always a Fibonacci number if you start from the center of the seed and you spiral out towards the edge. Count the number of seeds in each spiral and you'll get a Fibonacci number, though they get pretty big, like 144 or 233. Now let me go to a close relative of flowers. Well, I don't even know if it's a close relative, but close enough. It's the pine cone. Pine cones spiral. If you look at the spiral of a pine cone from the bottom to the top, like this spiral, if you count the petals, it'll always be a Fibonacci number. Unless you're a pine cone torturer and you pluck petals off. Oh, don't even talk about it. The same is true with pineapples. Don't you notice the spiral from the bottom to the top of a pineapple too? That's a Fibonacci number too. Okay, now let's say I turn you into a lumberjack. I say, cut down that tree for me. I give you a jetpack. So, you're a really good lumberjack, so you cut a perfectly horizontal plane from the tree. Then you use your jetpack and you fly up. You see, well, a bunch of stumps left of what was the tree. Count the number of stumps, and it will be a Fibonacci number. Try it. Okay, I think the most fascinating use of Fibonacci in nature is in your DNA. Even the microscopic realm is not immune to Fibonacci. A DNA molecule is 34 by 21 angstroms for each spiral of its double helix. So, those two are both Fibonacci numbers. Nature would not be possible without math. Hopefully you see how beautiful that black paint really is. Though you may spend hours doing math and we're saying, do math, I'm not your therapist, go solve your own problems. I understand that, I do it too. But, look out the window, go to the forest, explore our world, and find the math hidden there. Look at math from another angle, nature's angle, the right angle.